Hello, I'm Paul. If you're a regular viewer, you will perhaps know our 8-year-old daughter Emilie loves to sing, play piano, paint pictures, make animations and recordings, and we upload some of Emilie's videos to this channel from time to time. Our friend, the composer Alessandra Saletti, suggested late last year Emilie might like to play one of her piano compositions called LA 57. Emilie loved the piece, practiced it, and the music gave her the idea to paint a picture of what she thought the music looked like. We uploaded Emily's videos and Alessandra was very happy indeed. Alessandra became good friends with Emilie, and as a Christmas gift, she composed a song especially for Emilie to sing. Alessandra called it Emilie's Song. Emilie made two videos of this song with her pets on the piano, and we uploaded these videos as we normally do. If you're a classical pianist that makes home recordings of public domain works as we do, you will no doubt have had a number of those YouTube auto-generated copyright claims on your videos. This happens even with public domain works because reference files of commercially produced recordings are uploaded by record labels to YouTube's Content ID library for a degree of online copyright protection. However, in so doing, similarities between the reference waveforms of copyright protected audio and the waveforms of original audio recorded by YouTube musicians of the very same work inevitably occur. YouTube are aware of this situation, particularly affects the channels of self-recording classical musicians. When mistaken claims are made, YouTubers have the option to submit a dispute form, and in the majority of cases, but unfortunately not all, mistaken claims are reviewed by a human and released. And in a nutshell, that's the situation regarding copyright for classical musicians making and uploading their own original recordings of public domain works to their channels. Occasionally, YouTube generates a copyright claim that takes you by surprise. For example, yesterday we received a claim on Emilie's Song that appears to be on behalf of a YouTuber that goes by the name Ozyrys and comes via the label Merlin, Audio Salad, En Vivo, whoever they are. What surprises most about this particular claim is the audio is, as mentioned, an original song and, as mentioned, was especially written by Alessandra Saletti for our daughter Emilie. About this claim, Alessandra writes, Emilie's song is absolutely not from any publisher. I composed it for Emilie and that's all. I can't figure out who is claiming the copyright, but it's certainly not me. And whoever is doing it is not right. I searched Ozyrys and, to our surprise, we found a strange video. Emilie plays piano using Emilie's audio, and in the video description we noticed the video has been claimed as content belonging to Pedro, Lazaro, with the P symbol for phonographic copyright protection. What someone has done dishonestly to Emilie's song is therefore the explanation behind YouTube's copyright claim. I've linked to this strange video in the info, which, if you're interested, you can see for yourself at the time of making this video. And while I'm here, and perhaps connected, this channel is one of many channels targeted by scammers. Someone is making impersonation channels and posting comment replies to viewers with an invitation to message them on Telegram for gifts. As soon as I block the user, they make a new channel and it's an endless cycle. So if you see the scammer at work, please ignore them and be assured it's not me, even though this fake channel uses my logo and header. If I reply to a comment, it will come from this channel only, and the URL is Paul Barton Piano. Perhaps there's more to this claim than meets the eye. Perhaps it's not really Ozyrys, but instead a scammer abusing the Content ID system by uploading a fraudulent reference file to Content ID for reasons of their own. Scammers have done this to me before, and perhaps they put Ozyrys' name into it to get my attention. After all, Ozyrys has 2 million subs and it's irrational. A genuine YouTuber would do this so flagrantly to another YouTuber. Be assured, all your comments, encouragement and support for our videos are greatly appreciated. More than words can say. Thanks for watching. Stay safe.